Do you ask yourself now, I wish I'd known more about this, whatever this
Absolutely.
Is.
Absolutely.
I wish I had more sensitivity to this.
Well, I think you want to have a better understanding. I had very limited exposure to domestic violence, certainly from a personal standpoint. And that is something that, you know, I now understand that world a lot better.
It took what happened to make you understand.
Well, you go and I've been to shelters. I've been to a national hotline. You speak with survivors. You speak with advocates. And you understand better the complexity of this issue. When we were down at the hotline last fall, I really got a much deeper understanding of this. When you hear the fear that these advocates will tell you that the victims are feeling, the sense of helplessness, that all strikes you very personally. And as a father of twin girls and my wife, that's something that you don't want anyone to go through. And that's something that I think we as a league have learned. We are now in a better position to be able to deal with that in a responsible fashion. And I believe that our policies are actually going to have an impact well beyond football. I believe they're going to have an impact.
You want to set a standard?
Well, we want to take care of ourselves and we want to make sure that we're doing this right. But I believe we are setting a standard.
And how do you make sure it's not just that it's real, it's tough, and this league wants to prove to its fans and earn their trust, but impress the larger community, which you're talking about, that we're taking this really seriously.
I think
this is not just words.
Well, two things, Charlie. I think you're judged on by your actions, ultimately. How you do it. We have engaged experts that I think anybody in the broader community would say these people bring experience, wisdom, knowledge that will help us make better decisions going forward. And they are experts in their fields and the best of the best. And we've seen that in hiring Lisa Friel, who has 28 years down in the crime sex unit in New York. Todd Jones, who brings a wealth of experience in criminal justice system. Both at the federal government level and also in Minnesota. And so these are the kinds of people who are going to help us, I think, make better decisions, make sure our policies are kept up to speed. But the complexity of some of these areas are something that we really truly didn't understand how complex they were and how much we had to do to really deal with these things effectively.
And why didn't you really understand?
Because I don't think we understood the reliance on the criminal justice system was that they could deal with this and then we would respond based on what they find. What we found is that you can't rely simply on the criminal justice system, that you're gonna have to go out and get your own facts and you're gonna have to set your own standards and apply them to your standard, not to a criminal justice standard. They have reasons why they do certain things. They have reasons on why they will share certain information and not others. What we need to do is not be relying on them and be relying on ourselves.